Saints were actually rewarding some of their players for hurting players on the other team. Around $1,000 for knocking a guy out of the game. One player, Jonathan Vilma, who you see here, allegedly offered $10,000 to anyone who injured then-Vikings quarterback Brett Favre. Joining me now is Coy Wire. He's a former linebacker for the Atlanta Falcons and the Buffalo Bills. Coy, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Did this come as a surprise to you? When, in your days in the game, did you hear coaches say, I'm going to give you money if you take out a player?
Well, yeah, actually, I had the privilege of playing for Greg Williams.
And Greg Williams is the assistant coach of the Saints, who allegedly was in charge of this plot, right?
Right. You know, he was one of my favorite coaches of all time. Still is to this day. A great motivator, a great leader. Did he get carried away? Yes. What he did was wrong. He admits that now. And all the players who bought into that philosophy and that mentality of maliciousness were at fault, too, to some degree. And I think now that we know all that goes on with brain trauma, it's pertinent that we put an end to this type of behavior.
I guess, you know, I'm a huge football fan. I've been a long time. I mean, I used to go to Bears games at Wrigley Field. You probably even know they played in Wrigley Field before Soldier Field, where the Cubs played. But that's a whole other story. But I don't mean to be naive about it. I would think players would joke with each other about this and put up bets. But to have a member of the coaching staff say to the players, I'm going to give you extra money, you're going to get extra money for knocking a player out of the game, for impairing his health, for possibly hurting him forever, that just seems totally outrageous at its face.
This is a classic case of groupthink. Groupthink in psychology is a term describing a group of individuals, a large group of people will come together and do bad, irrational things, when as individuals, they would see and assess that same situation as being bad and wrong. It's what happens in cults. You get caught up in the moment, in the heat of the battle, and in something, in a sport like football, it's an uber-competitive sport. And the chase, the pursuit of the elusive Lombardi trophy sometimes causes guys to lose their heads a bit. But, you know, that's what makes this game exciting. It's the will to win and the guys who are willing to do anything to go out there and succeed.
Yeah, but you can win without doing stuff like this. And these are my next question. Do you think that other teams might also have coaches who are paying players to hurt other players?
I hope not. You know, I think that now...
I mean, in your days with the Bills, in your days with the Falcons, did you ever hear a coach say, I'm going to give you money if you knock a player out of the game?
That was the unique experience that I had with that. And I realized that afterwards when I had other coaches that wasn't the norm. That's not how things were in the NFL. You know, so I think that fault was admitted. And I respect Coach Greg Williams even more now for standing up and admitting his faults and taking ownership of the mistakes that he's made. And this is going to be a great moment for us because with player safety and health issues being such a hot button right now, it furthers the point that we really need to look out for our fellow teammates and the players of this game and the future of our game, because there's kids out there who are watching this sort of attitude and this maliciousness, this attitude that is harmful. And you can still play the game of football competitively with viciousness. It can be a violent game and an exciting game for fans, but we can still do it with respect for others. We can do it with integrity and with good old-fashioned sportsmanship. And I think that's the direction we need to go.
You brought up something important. You guys are our kids' role models.
That's right.
And you'll have to keep that in mind. So tell your friends who are on the field right now. That's how we all feel.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for your smart words. Nice seeing you, Coy.